the only thing she needs. We're gonna wrap it up right now with a little song called Night Road.
Down. It's been 10 long years, and we made it to some bad times. No way I could turn around. No way I could turn around. Yeah, yeah, yeah. My road's driving me down. Whoa, yeah, yeah. It's driving me down. Whoa, yeah, yeah. I said, my road's driving me down. Living with the woman, baby, you ain't got much time to get to where you wanna go. And in the back of your head was the thing that they said. It only makes my hunger grow. Yeah, I guess I'm doing way back when I was just a boy. Give my life to rock and roll. Then they're sneaking down the alleyway. To last with us about a year. When we thought they were behind us, working hand in hand, one by one they disappear. Hey, they'll never find a way back as I become a man, giving it my heart and soul. So we're driving down the mountain road, leave them all behind. No way I could turn around. It's been 10 long years, yeah, we made it through the bad times. No way I could turn around. No way I could turn around. Yeah, I know. Still got a long, long way to go. Ooh, yeah. But you know, we gonna ride till the end of the road. I said to keep on trying, keep on fighting, somewhere to go. Thank you, let's see you later.
Thanks very much. We'll see you later on. Thank you. The only thing she needs. We're gonna wrap it up right now with a little song called Night Road. We'll be right back.
Happy Wednesday.
Oh, have we got trouble for you.
That's right. We're sorry for Gail. We're sorry that you're sick.
Yes. Always not fun to hear when someone's not feeling well, and the chairs are all in place, and we're sending you the good universal vibes from space.
Right. We knew something was up because we have not seen you in a while, but we figured, hey, maybe she just wanted to take a break.
We figured, hey!
And we're not going to, like, say, hey, why aren't you here? Because if you wanted to, like, leave,
no,
that would have been weird.
That's weird. That's weird.
That would have been weird.
So, oh, hey! Yes.
So Sue's saying happy birthday to Todd, and
you know, and
I should have
played a Todd video tonight, but I didn't.
Happy birthday, Todd!
But happy birthday, 72 Todd!
72 years old.
Is he 72?
Yes, he is. Yes, he
I should
is.
Show the, I should show some of those pictures sometime.
The teeth.
I have the teeth.
I know you have the teeth. No, the teeth pictures.
What? That's what I'm saying.
Yeah.
Yeah. Do I have the... Well, you know what? That would be fun for his birthday. Fucking kidding.
Hey, he took the pictures.
Oh, man. He's fun. He's fun.
Unless you're John.
John didn't get it.
No.
John...
You know what?
Couldn't... It's
because
like...
John didn't try.
Well, no. I know why John didn't get it.
Why?
Because... Todd was snappy and quick and funny, and if John wasn't hearing it or didn't get it, you know, that's... And it wasn't that... They just didn't
John
hang out
liked
a lot.
Snappy and quick.
Right, when he can hear it. He likes to be snappy and quick.
Yeah, but he liked you because you were snappy and quick.
Yeah, but I was loud enough for him to hear. I don't know. I mean, I, you know... John was not zany.
No, he was not zany.
He didn't really like zany.
He was eccentric, but not zany.
No, he was eccentric, but that's a whole different story.
Yeah.
But we have...
Oh, man, we got some rarities.
We got never-before-played videos.
Oh, my gosh, do
got,
we?
Got not one, but two. Pat Romano, is he in the room?
Yes, he is.
We have two, not one, but two. Unseen and... For all I know, unheard Rat Race Choir performances.
Right, and we hope you had a very good birthday, Pat.
Yes, yes, happy birthday, you old geezer.
It How was
old
yesterday. Is he now?
Do we get to know?
Oh, I don't. Do you need to know?
Not really.
Okay.
I need to know. I need to know.
I need to know if you really love me.
Oh, wow, so we're doing Whitney?
That's what came to mind.
Is that the one that TM played on? Everybody gave him so much. Man, you're hanging with Whitney now. T.M. Stevens, God bless you wherever you are, man. I hope he's okay. I don't know if, you know. Well, anyway, no gloom. T.M. would want no gloom.
Mm-hmm.
So, yeah, I found some cool stuff to share with you. And a couple of these things, they're videos that people made for me of things that I've done over the years or... in the case of this first one, it was actually, the event was broadcast, you know, on screens, and it was, I think, I don't remember what else they did with it, but anytime there's screens, there's usually a recording source.
Yeah.
So, and this was a concert that we did...
when we first moved down here,
yeah,
actually.
Yeah, that was... what? Oh, no.
Oh, no.
Oh,
well, we moved
no.
down here August of 04.
Right.
But this wasn't any kind of hurricane relief thing or anything.
Well, it was to Ben. It was March of Dimes. And
that was not hurricane relief.
No, it wasn't hurricane relief.
So I think this was like the first one.
This was the first one. This was, hey, Steve, welcome to Florida. Can you call your friends and put on a show?
Right. And Eddie was in rare form. Oh, Eddie Money was in rare
God.
Form.
This is, if you've ever heard me tell the golfing story about Eddie, right? We're going down the fairway in a golf cart. This is a charity, mucky muck, high-end charity golf tournament. And Eddie's going, Stevie, turn around, I dropped. And in the middle of the fairway, flapping in the breeze, is an ounce of pop. That's this show.
He lost his shoe.
Lost one of his shoes.
And they were like introducing a new development in Fort Myers that they had just built called Magnolia Landing.
Right. But they did donate the proceeds from the thing to the March of Dimes and the Children's Cancer Trust.
Yes. And they gave all of the musicians one of the model homes to use as a dressing room. Remember, let me tell you that,
too well. too very too well. Now you gotta realize these are corporate real estate guys, which are a whole nother kind of corporate, right? I mean, they, you know, like WCI or Pulte or any of these places that build country clubs and that kind of stuff. And they are corporate.
And at the end of the night of that concert, when we all went back to that model home, Eddie was freaking trashed.
Yeah, he was trashed. But we
and
don't want to go.
He had mentioned something about it.
Huh?
He had been in rehab 3 times.
No, he says, no, that was... Anyway.
Oh, wait.
What?
Chris has a question for
Who
you.
Who does?
Chris.
Can
you ask Steve if he knows the drums... 2, Only Human by Utopia, my favorite album, Swing to the Right, True Story. Do you know what he's saying?
Yeah, he's asking me if I know how to play that song, and I don't, because I don't, I mean, I not that I don't know
I
how to play it.
I have never heard that one.
Well, I'm sure it's Willie Wilcox, but...
Not Prairie Prince?
He was later.
Oh.
I think that he's talking...
So the name of the song is Swing to the Right? No, the album is Swing to the Right. Only Human must be the song?
Yeah.
Okay.
Well, I'll look it up. And
that must
then,
not have been one of his hits.
Well, you know, and you got to understand something. I, as much of a music lover as I was as a kid, you know, teens, which is pretty cool because these songs are all kind of part of that. But I don't listen to a lot of music because I write music or create music all the time. So I don't, you know, if Todd, something by Todd is playing, of course I'm listening to it, but I'm not one of the guys that goes out and has every album and knows everybody's name. It's just,
well, he wants to know if you can play the drum part. You know
I'm
what?
Sure I can.
There is no drum part that Steve cannot play. This Let me tell you that, people.
Oh.
Okay.
Wow, you should see. She's in a little plaid skirt, got a Letterman sweater on and some pom-poms. I'm like, this is freaking great.
I have not known. Okay, has there been any song that you cannot play?
Not that I know. There's nothing.
I rest my case. So you don't need to ask him anymore if he knows how to play a song.
Yeah, there's nothing that I... Well, I think he's asking me if I know the way it goes. I've never found anything that I can't play. I don't know a song out there that has a beat in it or something that I can't do if I...
He played Mahavishnu Orchestra.
Yeah, but that doesn't... You know, that's Willie Wilcox, and if it's Willie Wilcox in that... Utopia thing. He's a totally different drummer than Billy Cobham or, you know. And, all right.
No,
here,
Sue
Chris,
agrees with me. Sue agrees with me.
Thank you very much, Sue. Let me tell you a quick story, Chris, okay? Right to you. Billy Cobham and I are doing a clinic together somewhere in New York. And at the end of the show, I went on first and did my, whatever it was, 20 minutes, and then Billy came out and did his 20 minutes, and then I think we played at the end together. I don't really remember what, you know, what the format was. But at the end of the show, everybody's gone, and the two drum sets are sitting there. And I asked him...
Brenda agrees with me, too.
All right, guys.
Okay.
Shucks. And I asked, I can't remember the song... It's a Mahavishnu Orchestra. I can never remember the name of it. It's either Intermounting Flame or something like that. And I said, how do you play that? You know, because Billy plays lefty on a right-handed kit. I mean, he's amazing. And so he plays this beat for me that I know how to play. I mean, I can play it. And he's not doing it anything like what I was doing. because I'm a righty on a righty set. He's a lefty. And so here's the point, Chris. I said to him, that's how that goes? And he goes, yeah. And I said, it's not how I play it. And he said, how do you play it? And I showed him what I did. And he was like, what? So it's not...
Well, listen,
Billy Cobham, you can't take anything away from Cobham, but everybody has their own way of walking, you know.
Yes,
what I mean?
And Chris does hold his left hand like you do, Steve.
He does, like this. It's conventional, but the question is, Chris, is it a French grip or a German grip?
Seriously?
Yeah, you can come back to me on it. I'm going to move on anyway.
Okay, let's play our first song.
Yeah,
shall
somebody
we?
Was asking me for backstage passes. I said they only gave me 2 tickets.
To paradise.
Okay, anyway, like I said,
Eddie Money.
Like I said,
Steve
all they gave me was 2 tickets. Eddie, please bail me out, buddy. They gave me 2 tickets to paradise.
Got a surprise now, especially for everybody out there tonight. Something that all of us have always wanted to do. Come on, come on. Waited so long. Let me hear you.
Waited so long.
I can't hear you. So far from here. How about Hawaii? I've got 2 tickets in my pocket, baby. We'll disappear. Your turn, everybody.
Waiting so long.
I can't hear you.
Waiting so long.
I still can't hear you.
Waiting so long.
Waiting so long. Waiting so long. I've got. How are we doing up here? Whoa, 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 whoa. You want to go to Hawaii? I want to hear you.
Whoa, 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 whoa,
whoa. I'm taking everybody. Can you hear me? I said I'm taking everybody. If you clap your hands, come on. Come on. Raise some money for the March of Dimes. Kids with Cancer, the American Cancer Foundation. I said yeah, 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 yeah.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
I can't hear you. I said yeah, 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 yeah.
Yeah, 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 yeah.
Yeah, yeah, yeah,
yeah.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
Whoa, 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 whoa.
I'm taking everybody. I'll take you on a trip so far from here. I got 2 tickets in my pocket, baby. We'll disappear. We're waiting so long. Come on.
Waiting so long.
Everybody, come on.
Waiting so long.
Waiting so long. Waiting so long. I've got 2 tickets to paradise. Back in bed to leave tonight. 2 tickets to paradise. 2 tickets to paradise. 2 tickets to paradise. band you'll need tonight. Two tickets to Paradise. Two tickets. Two tickets. Paradise.
See?
Yeah.
And it's funny, I mean, I haven't seen that since we did it in oh something. Oh shit. Oh five, maybe? No.
Yeah, something like that.
I don't know, but I have such rare videos tonight for you.
So Sue wants to know if Eddie was from Baldwin. We know he was...
He lived on Long Island, but I think he was from...
He was from Brooklyn, but he grew up in Long Island. We don't know what town, but she thinks maybe her friend sort of dated him. Her friend Suzanne.
I don't doubt it. I don't doubt it. And it's funny because I know Eddie from the 70s because the girl who cut my hair for 25 years was the same girl that cut his hair. Mm-hmm. And that's a nice way to, you know, get to know somebody.
Okay, Richard says it's basically Torque, the backing band.
Yes. Except that was Ken Levinsky on keyboards,
not in Torque.
Not Chris Clark, who was not.
Yeah, you never saw this, Gail. We have others you have never seen.
And I'll tell you what, one of the, you know, the...
Oh, well, now TV John says that Eddie was from Levittown.
Yeah, he probably lived in Levittown, but I think he was from the city.
Though. He was from Brooklyn, but he grew up in Long Island. I just looked at it.
Okay, well then why didn't you say so?
I did.
Okay, I said.
It didn't say what town. TV says.
Am I still hearing
Levittown.
Stuff?
Levittown. Yep.
What is that?
Something over there.
I
don't know. Remy's turned the TV off, so he's not watching.
Anyway, how about those backing vocalists? You had Mark Farner, Joe Lynn Turner, Krista Fogelsong, and Henry Smith.
Now, Krista is a local news girl anchor. She's like
she's our ABC news anchor. And, I've known Krista. God, how did we meet Krista? Oh, she did a story when we were doing... When Arnie, Cliff, and I were doing TJ Kelly in the studio.
Really?
Yeah, that's how, that was a...
Yeah. I don't recall that.
Yeah, at Unity Game. She came to do a story on it. Yeah, I remember that.
Okay, anyway. So TV says, Steve, at one time he lived down the block from my friend Mary Ann. You remember her?
I remember Mary Ann.
Yep, so he says
I remember Mary Ann.
Okay, so he lived down the block from Mary Ann.
And one of the, two of the tracks that I'm going to play, TV, you were definitely at these shows.
Ooh.
Absolutely in these shows.
I know it's true.
And, Jesus.
Our minds got fried.
Yeah, but we can't eat.
I'm not telling why, but man, the last one, it fried our minds.
Yeah, the last song of the night is going to really get you.
So, I don't know if it's going to get them, but it got us.
It got us. Really, I mean, I told you I was going to bring some new stuff out.
That's right.
And man, do I have new stuff. I mean, I have stuff. It's not new stuff, but it's...
Stuff
you
that
haven't
we have
seen
not
it.
Seen in...
It's archival, yeah.
Years
stuff
and
that
years
we haven't seen
years.
In 30 years, 40, I don't know.
Some of them.
Anyway, let's see. So what do I have next? I don't remember what I picked. Oh, yes, I do. And the thing about...
I have it.
I know you do. The thing about all of the... Well, the thing about the song after this one, you know, I've told you how many times I... got up in the morning to Never in My Life, you know, the Leslie West track, and then what a dream it was to open every show with that, with Leslie. I mean, it's one thing if you play it with your band, you know what I mean? That's just, it's cool because it's a great song to play, but when you're playing it with the guy who made it cool in the first place, there's something cool about that. And it's, not this particular song, although this was a lot of fun to play, we've known Donald for a long time, but I'll tell you that story before we play that video, because time marches on. Oh, but wait.
Time does march on.
It does march on. Mm-hmm. Hang on, what do we got here? Oh, I have stuff. Watch this. Just watch. Just a trick of the
that
light?
Was close to funeral in the friend.
That's not funeral for a friend. That's,
it was close to the bell.
That's shirt for a rock star. Oh. Trick of the light. Oh. Yeah, and for you Entwistle aficionados, that's the shirt, is called Trick of the Light. And Chris
Entwistle,
I sent him number one in his size, which he wore when the, I don't know.
The who were got, dedicated
yeah,
for something.
Yeah, they got inducted or something, I don't know, yeah. Something like that.
He wore that with John's spider necklace.
Yeah, it was cool.
Yeah. Okay, time for our next song or we're not going to get through them.
Okay, we're not going to get through them. See, that's a little positive energy there.
Well,
but
it's 7:21 and you
okay,
got
well, now the sound on some
more
of these is not the best in the world because like they said, they were, this one was shot by a good friend and a little too close to the band with that camera, but you get the idea.
Okay. Are you
going to
see who it is?
No. Do I need to say who it is? It's Buck Dharma from Blue Oyster Cult.
Woohoo!
Wait a minute. I think I hear something big coming this way right now.
Thank you.
Yeah, that was fun.
So that was
Germaine Arena. Mm-hmm. And, that was
a hurricane relief concert that...
That on what?
K-Rock put on.
Yeah.
Right.
What is that?
I don't know.
You're hearing it, though, right?
I am.
Are people, like, outside the house?
No, maybe the TV's on.
Okay.
I'll go see.
Are you hearing it?
I did.
Not you, them.
I heard it.
You did hear
it? So that was Mark Farner on backing vocals and Joe Lynn, because they all performed.
Yeah. Yeah, and I was, I've got Joe Lynn's set, Mark's set, and actually I'm playing something from Mark's set, Mark Farner's set.
No TV on in here.
Uh-oh. Well, that's weird. What?
Is it not you doubling something?
Nah. No TV on in here.
I see Jim and the Wizard walking by, but you can never usually hear them.
No, you can't hear them.
Well,
and there's nobody outside. It's something strange.
Something strange.
I just heard it again. It's not the dog?
No. It's something on your
thing. I'm going to get my gun.
It's on your thing.
No, I don't think so. It's okay. All right, anyway. This next little toe tapper.
Oh.
This is Pat Romano. This is a Rat Original.
And I
am pretty sure that you've never heard this one. I mean, you might have heard the song. But I don't think you've heard or seen the performance. What?
Because it was at our wedding. In 1984.
Why don't you just give it all away? Why don't you? You think they would have known?
No, they would not have known.
See, she does. This is what she does. Just gives the punchline to everything.
That's
what you do. You know what? I've got these little things over here, and I can throw them at you, and I will. If I don't want you to get, because I thought you were going to give up that.
Yes!
Really? You want to go there? Yeah, it's just hello 911. There's been a murder.
Okay.
There's been a murder.
Yes. All right, let's hear this little toe tapper.
There she goes. Bye bye. Little toe tap.
TV. I knew it. Your wedding. I was there.
I said that.
Thank you.
changed.
And the weather was like perfect.
It was. It was.
Nice
it is
September
us.
Day.
I do hear us.
Yep, I do too.
They do exist. I don't know why that is.
No, Skip was not at our wedding.
No, Skip was not at our wedding. Nope. I don't know what that is. Anyway. Mm-hmm. I couldn't remember half the people that were at that wedding.
No.
But it amazed me. You know, I'm looking at everybody, and it looked like we all got haircuts from the same person.
Nah, I doubt it.
No, I don't think they could. No. I don't
Who
think she
was the girl in the blue left of Dave? That was Dave's girlfriend at the time, Lynn.
Yeah, that if you remember when we had Laura Black on the show, she was in a band called, help me out here.
The Skirts.
I was right in it.
And Lynn was the drummer.
And she was the drummer. Lynn was the drummer.
Mm-hmm.
So, there's that. So now what? Let's see. Now what? Well, okay. So now that, and I tell you, I love that song. That was a great track. It was fun to play, and Dave sang a great vocal in there. You know, it was great. It was fun. That was 1984, September 9th, if I'm not mistaken. So
really,
yeah, and you too can have what?
If you're not mistaken,
I'm not mistaken. Okay. Oh, all right. She's well. You know what? We're going to talk about mistaken. Not this next video, but the video at the end of the show. We're going to tell you something about mistaken. Okay.
But, okay.
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 So now what? Okay. So now.
So now.
This is one of those songs that you learn when you're a kid because it's like a really cool song and you have to learn it. You have to know how it goes. And if you're in a good enough band, you wind up playing it. And then you don't play it anymore because whatever, you move on or you learn new other songs and whatever. And this song sort of drifts away into the background of your life, unless it's on your playlist or something, which it's not. But then, 30 years later, you wind up on the stage playing that song again in front of a packed arena with the guy who wrote it. That's cool. And it's not a cover song when you're doing it that way, right? But anyway, that really has very little to do with it. But this is Mark Farner. We were at Germain Arena, and this is probably one of the all-time iconic Grand Funk Railroad songs, and this would be Torque, because I believe Chris Clark was on keyboards in this one. Jeff was playing bass, Mark was playing guitar, and we had Paul Pesco playing guitar as well.
And Joe Lynn was probably singing back.
Joe Lynn and I forget who else was back. Well, Jolynn and
Buck.
Buck, yeah, would have been back. And, you know, these things, to do these kind of things, it's really, really fun because you get to play all of your favorite songs with all of the people that did them. I mean, it's cool if you play Godzilla, but if you play Godzilla with Buck, it's a little cooler.
Yeah.
And he was great. I mean, he's still a good friend. I've spoke to him not too long ago, and he's been on the show, as those of you Lawners will remember. So anyway.
Lawners.
Lawners. Yeah. Who phoned the lawn?
Okay.
So this is Germain Arena, hurricane relief concert, Torque, for lack of a better word, with Mark Farner. And the sound is not great, but the experience really was. And I've done this a few times with Mark over the years, but I don't know, this was the first time I think we ever played it together, and it was freaking cool. Check it out. Man, I just got a chill watching that. That was a moment. And, you know, Grand Funk, that is Grand Funk. It's not, I mean, it's not. What I mean is, it's the song and the voice. He was great, Mark. And still a good friend to this day. He's had some real trials in his life, but guy's a consummate professional.
Yeah.
Now, this last video of the evening is a rarity.
That we haven't even seen.
We haven't watched this yet. We just know what it is. Now, I kind of gave it away with the with the wedding video of Rat Race, but I don't know how do I set this up, honey? First of all, if you've heard about the trauma of our wedding dance, I don't know if we've told the story, but we actually researched the lyrics to the song, if you remember.
Whiter Shade of Pale.
Whiter Shade of Pale, and we thought, you know, what was that? You know what?
We thought that was the only
Only slow song the Rat Race knew.
Yep.
And we remember distinctly
that
was the name.
We hadn't planned on dancing because I don't dance.
No, she doesn't dance.
And I did not plan it.
Not in public, anyway.
And you didn't say, hey, we have to pick some song to dance to. And
you know what?
Pressured into dancing.
Pressured?
Yes, forced to, against our will. At our own wedding.
Just see if you can sense any awkwardness.
I don't dance either, Sue. I don't dance either.
She just, I mean, I don't, although I did come in second on that Dancing with the Stars.
Because you took some lessons for that.
Well, no, I rehearsed for that.
Our wedding, that's the first time I ever slow danced, and the second time, the first and only time I slow danced
in my life. I was grinding her, too.
No, you were not.
This is just the body language. We know what she's saying. Can we stop doing this now? And it's there's a camera on her. This is just,
I don't like to be in the spotlight. We going to, say anything else?
What are we going to say? That we got the song wrong?
It turns out it was not.
It was not Whiter Shade of Pale.
And we just learned that today when we saw this.
Well,
I don't know if anybody else forgot their wedding song, but since we never picked one out.
Yeah, what's your, I mean, we've been, every time we hear Whiter Shade of Pale, we go, oh! Fucking idiots.
Okay, so here we go.
All right, so yeah, you're going to enjoy this.
Yeah.
Franny, I hope you're watching. You get to see Barbie dance.
Oh, God. Not ready for this. I didn't even know the lines to the sermon. And then I got this. I knew somebody was going to ask who was on the drums. Chris Catalano. C-A-T. How do you spell Catalano? C-A-T-A-L-A-N-O. I look like I'm going to fall over. You are, because I'm trying to escape. Is that Butch? Oh, somebody walking by a little. That we don't know. Oh, that's who I thought was Butch. Radio Corwin?
What am I doing?
Paris Hilton. I'm looking like, right. Okay, we can stop doing this now. Paris Hilton likes the camera.
Oh, shit, man. That's it. Yeah.
Oh, my cat. My mic was on that whole time. Oh, shit. So, yeah, that was it. And I shall be released.
But you weren't released, were you?
No.
Did you see her trying to escape?
I had to stay there. I was like, can't we stop doing this now? Wow.
That's, yeah. Do we have to keep doing it? I mean, that's the whole... She was chattering like a nervous bride through the whole thing. I mean, I don't want to really be dancing either. My whole Italian family was there.
I think they're the ones that made us.
They made us.
Well,
aren't you glad that we did that? Look at all the joy we're getting out of it now.
Yeah.
And Chris finally gets to see what you look like. So, let's see now. Well, that about wraps it up for tonight. Tomorrow is Throwback Thursday.
Mm-hmm.
So, get ready for some stories from yesteryear. What?
Gail said, Steve, if you opened your coat, she would have crawled in.
I'm telling you, she didn't know what to do with her arms. She didn't know what to do.
And Sue says, probably Italians do guilty shit. I know it was his cousin Debbie that
was... Oh, shit, because she might be watching the show, Deb.
She was the one that was
the one. Her and Sergeant Cecily were the ones. Well, because they were... Look, you know, that wedding... First of all, Rat Race Choir... only did two weddings ever that I remember.
Yeah.
And one of them we didn't show up to because we were taking pictures out in Montauk, and the other one was that. I don't think we played any other weddings. But I digress. We did everything ourselves. We didn't, the father of the bride, it was none of that stuff.
No.
And... The last thing I wanted was anybody involved in it, you know. And the people that were there was an incredible...
We didn't have a whole lot of time to plan it either, because you proposed to me when you were at the hospital. You proposed to me.
We didn't have a lot of time to plan it. Who picked the frickin' date?
I did.
Okay, so why didn't we have a lot of time to plan it?
Because I picked the closest date that I could before you backed out.
Well, wait a minute. It was July 6th that I got in the thing. And
you didn't get out of the hospital till what? The
8 days.
Okay, the 14th.
Right, so that was the day I asked you to marry me.
Yes, and I said, okay, September 9th. Yep. If I had waited any longer, he would have squirmed out of it.
I don't think so. I asked you to marry me, didn't I?
Yes, you did.
I was thinking I was in a hospital bed figuring I was going to die any minute.
No, you were out of ICU at that time.
No, I knew. You know, look, I thought you were going to turn tail and run. That's what I thought. I thought she was going to say, I'm out of here. And she was at that hospital every day.
That's right.
Yep.
Giving you ice chips.
Ugh.
You couldn't drink.
No. But eventually... And I recovered fast, thank God. I mean, I had I'll tell that on July 6th,
yeah.
Which is the second anniversary of this format of the show.
I know.
Who even knew
Randy.
That? Yeah. Well.
Mm-hmm.
So yeah, I'll tell the I survived heavy metal story on July 6th. So anyway, that's I was going through. You know, I did say I would digitize some new stuff, and I was in the studio working, and I came across this book of DVDs. It's around here somewhere. And I have a really cool program in there that just will convert the DVD to whatever format you want. And you know, it was just fun to see all that stuff. And all of a sudden I see wedding video, and I said, what? And that's, it's pretty long. I mean, the guy who made the video interviewed everybody.
Well, that was his gift to us.
Yeah, that was his gift to us. Mm-hmm. And so, you know, and we did the wedding ourselves. We planned the food, which there was no food.
There was food.
Why? Because you and your friend got wired and made 1,000 deviled eggs.
That's... No, and somebody brought lasagna. And somebody brought some Swedish meatballs. And there was that delicious cake.
And, there was,
and everybody was so wired they weren't eating anyway.
And there was beer and champagne.
Somebody gave us cases of Korbel.
Cases of Korbel.
So people were drinking before we even said, I do. It was a party before. There was no reception. It was just a big party.
No, it was just, the cops came because we were playing outside, obviously. The band was playing outside. And there were... God, what was that? There was 100 or so people there.
Yeah,
it was, and it was weird because watching your wedding video back, which we haven't done, in decades.
We still haven't watched the whole thing. We just
we're
found
afraid
out
to watch
that
the whole thing.
We've been saying the wrong song this whole time.
Yeah, we've been saying the wrong
years.
Song. So now, and we'll never hear "I Shall Be Released" on the radio. So there goes that. But
I don't know how we came up with "White or Shade of Pale." I know they played that. Somebody.
I will have to watch. You know, we'll
watch the video.
Instead of Star Wars or the Avengers, we'll watch our wedding video. But it was just so strange. Yeah, that's right. We're doing Peaky Blinders again. Mm-hmm. But it was so strange to watch a video and see the clusters of people from the different parts of my life. I mean, some of my oldest friend, my very best and oldest friend, Chris Peck. If you saw.
He was singing backgrounds.
He was singing backgrounds with Dave.
Yep.
He was in the middle.
It was his house.
It was his house.
It was his yard we
and
got married.
There was another thing that I was going to say.
And Chris Catalano was one of your drum students and a very good friend.
Yeah. Oh, well, Chris Catalano. Okay, if you remember the Steve Stevens episode, Steve talks about the guy who took him, calls him Chrissy, who took him to see Rat Race for the first time, mm-hmm. and it blew him away. That's
they
who
were
that
in
was.
One hand clap together.
Yeah, they were in one hand clap together, and Chris was a very close friend of ours, and it was Chris, because we were living upstate, way far away, and the hospital was in the Bronx. Chris let Lori stay over with him and his girlfriend, and he drove her to the hospital.
Every day.
Every day, even though he couldn't come in and visit, because I'm in ICU.
Mm-hmm.
But, great friend, and you're lucky to know people like that in your life.
That's right.
And he's gone, and
gone but not forgotten.
Gone but not forgotten, and certainly not certainly appreciated. Not forgotten, and so on and so forth. So on that somewhat somber note,
we have a Throwback Thursday tomorrow night.
Throwback Thursday, so I'm going to pick some funny ones for you. Be sure you tune up before the show so that you're ready. And if I don't see you in the future, I'll see you in the pasture.
Good night, everybody.
Good night, kids. See ya. Ooh, look at that. ¶¶